Hello and welcome to the inaugural episode of N Squared. For my first video, I will be showing you how to make a ridiculously cheap analog pressure sensor. So first, you'll want to cut a small piece of static dissipative foam that will be your pressure sensor. This is the type of foam many chips you buy come embedded in, so you might have some just lying around. In case you don't have any, there is a link in the description. Now, cut two wires for the positive and negative charge. They can be as long as you want, but I'm going to make them fairly short because this sensor isn't for any specific project. Now cut the ends of the wires a little longer than the foam piece you have because you will eventually be poking the wire through the foam. Normally, I would use wire strippers, however, I have lost mine, so I'll be using a pocket knife, which, as you are about to see, isn't something I'd tried before, but I get there eventually. Don't judge. Now poke the exposed part of the wire all the way through the foam so it comes out of the opposite side. It may take a few tries, but after you do that, bend the wire sticking out back through the top of the foam so you can't pull the wire out of the foam. Then do the same thing you just did, but with the other wire. However, make sure the two wires don't touch, and make sure they won't touch if you press on the foam piece, or else the sensor won't work. When you're done, your pressure sensor should look something like this from the side. Now you need to cut the other ends of both wires so you can connect the sensor to your projects. Again, you get to see my amazing skills at stripping wire insulation with a knife. Jealous? But seriously, where are my wire strippers? Finally, after that, you should probably test the sensor. You don't have to, but you can't go back after this next step, and it'll take a long time. I was having some problems with my multimeter, but after I sorted those out, you can see that when I apply pressure to the foam, the resistance changes pretty well. You want to press in between the wires. If you press them toward each other, they might touch, depending on how close you put them, which may or may not be what you want depending on your applications. Finally, if you want to stiffen up the sensor and make it a bit more durable for some applications, you can optionally coat the sensor in liquid electric tape or Plastidip. I chose the liquid electric tape linked below. Completing this step is as simple as taking the lid off the bottle and dunking the sensor in. Then set the sensor in a pair of helping hands to dry. The part of my hand that just got tape on it was really irritated the next day, so be careful not to get any liquid electric tape on you when you do this. You then have to wait for Earth to spin about 180 degrees until morning for the electric tape to dry. After that long process, your pressure sensor should be done. Just check your multimeter to make sure it's working properly. As you can see with mine, the resistance doesn't change as much because it's much stiffer when pressing it. If you'd like to stiffen it up even more for your application, you can just give it more dips in the liquid electric tape, letting it dry each time. Alright, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the first ever N Squared video. If you did, consider liking, favoriting, and sharing it. Subscribe so you can catch all the amazing robotics, electronics, and 3D printing projects I have planned. Also comment on what you liked and what you didn't so I can make future videos even better. Thanks for watching.